If you stream directly from your Xbox, you know that you could only stream to Twitch. So in today's video, I'm going to show you how you can go ahead and stream to Twitch and YouTube at the same time without the need of having a capture card or buying expensive gear. So by the end of this video, you'll be streaming on both Twitch and YouTube to be able to grow on both platforms. Let's go ahead and dive in. So the first thing we're going to want to do is on our Xbox, we want to make sure that our destinations and our settings for Twitch are correct. That way our stream on YouTube looks professional. So on your Xbox controller, you want to hit the home button. You're going to come over to the icon right before your profile picture. You're going to hit start stream. So what this is going to do is going to give you the settings for Twitch if you haven't set them up already. So what I want to do is I want to come here to where it says more options of their settings. You want to come to where it says 1080p, 6000 kbps is what you want to have. But this is all going to be based on your internet speed. So if you have at least a 10 upload, you can go ahead and go to the max of 6000. So once you have that in place, your destination is going to be Twitch. We want to go ahead and jump over to a mobile device, a laptop, a computer to be able to get this initial step set up so we can get connected over to YouTube. So let's go ahead and jump over to the computer now. All right, so now that we're on the computer, you're going to want to go to the description of this video and you're going to want to go to aircast.app. This is going to be the tool that's going to allow us to be able to take whatever we're streaming to Twitch to send it over to YouTube for us without the need of having to utilize a capture card. So now Aircast is not free. It is going to cost you a little bit to be able to go ahead and utilize it. Now they have an essential plan and a streamer plan and you get a 14-day free trial to be able to try it out. The streamer plan is the one that I recommend. This video is not sponsored by them. It's just a tool that I've found to make it available for you to be able to stream on more than just Twitch when all you have is your Xbox. Now, the reason why I say the streamer plan is because here they have an auto start feature, and that auto start feature is going to be extremely important. This is also going to give you access to be able to stream to more than just YouTube, but I want to explain to you the auto start feature. So the auto start, what it's going to mean is that once you go live on your Xbox on Twitch, it's going to automatically push your stream over to YouTube, so you'll be live on both. Now, one thing to keep in mind, if you are a Twitch affiliate and you don't want to break your terms of service by streaming to multiple platforms at the same time, what I recommend is that you make a separate Twitch account for this exact scenario. So you'll utilize that account connected to your Xbox just so you can send the stream to Twitch. And in all reality, what you ultimately want is to send that stream to YouTube, and then you don't have to worry about terms of service and you're able to start building up your YouTube. So let's go ahead and keep following through this to show you how to get this all set up so you can start streaming on YouTube today. All right, so once you've gone ahead and selected the plan or started the trial, you're going to be brought to a dashboard just like this. The first thing we're going to want to do is we want to go ahead and connect our Twitch account. So here where it says stream input, you want to go ahead and hit stream with Twitch. It's going to go ahead and ask Aircast to get access to your Twitch account. You simply want to select authorize. Once you do that, you're going to see here on the left-hand side that now your Twitch account is displayed. You want to go ahead and select the auto start. Again, remember, this is going to say when your stream goes live, it's going to go ahead and push YouTube live as well. And then the experimental stream engine, you can turn that on as well. So now we have our Twitch connected. The next thing we want to do is we want to go ahead and add our YouTube. So we'll come here to where it says add stream output. And then you want to go ahead and select YouTube. This is going to go ahead and ask you for a stream key. Now, one key thing that you need to know about the stream key is that to be able to get it, you have to come to your YouTube channel. You'll click on this little camera icon and you'll select go live. If you've never live streamed to YouTube before, you're going to get a message just like this. It's going to say request access to streaming. Once requested, it may take 24 hours to get access to live streaming. So don't be alarmed if you get that message. It just simply means that for the first time, you're going to have to wait 24 hours. You don't need a certain amount of subscribers to be able to gain access to live streaming on YouTube. And then once the 24 hours have stopped, then you'll get access to the stream key to be able to go connect it to Aircast so you can start streaming to YouTube. But if you do have access, you can continue following along with this video. So let's go jump back into the computer. So if you do have access to live streaming on YouTube, you'll be brought to a dashboard just like this when you select go live. Now, a few things that we want to go ahead and set up on this side before we go ahead and get our stream key is that on the right hand side, you want to come and select edit. This is where you're going to want to go ahead and put your stream title. Then you're going to want to put in your description with maybe your social links, what your stream's about. You want to make sure that that information is there. Then here, super important for visibility, you want to make sure that this is set to public. If you do not set this to public, people will not be able to see your stream. But if you want to do a test stream, then you can go ahead and leave it as unlisted, and then only you would be able to view it. But if you want other people to see it, you want to make sure you have it on public. Then here on the category, you want to make sure you select gaming if you're going to be doing gaming, and then you'll be able to upload your thumbnail, add it to a playlist, and also select the game that you're going to stream. Now, mind you, you're only going to have to set this up one time, and then you can continue to utilize this information or update it if you want every stream. And I recommend that you update your stream title every time that you go live. So once you have that in place, to get our stream key, you're going to come here to the left-hand side. It's going to say stream key. We want to go ahead and copy that information, and we want to come back to Aircast, and we want to go ahead and paste that in there. And then once you go ahead and paste it in there, you want to make sure you select auto start. Again, this is going to make sure that it's going to go live automatically once we go live on Twitch. So go ahead and hit save. Okay, now we'll see here that now we have our Twitch input and we have our YouTube. So what we want to do now is we want to go back to our Xbox and go live on Twitch. Let's go ahead and jump over to the Xbox now. So on the Xbox, you now want to go ahead and select go live. We'll give it a few minutes for it to initialize. And then once you're live on Twitch, we'll go ahead and confirm that here in just a moment. So let's go over to our Twitch channel to make sure that we're live. All right. So if you see that we here are on Twitch, you can see that I am now live. Of course, I'm on the Xbox dashboard, so I'm going to get this loading screen as opposed to a game. So you want to make sure you load up a game to be able to get that. So now we want to do is look at Aircast, and we see now that we are online on Twitch and we're also online on YouTube. So now we're on live on both. So let's go ahead and jump over to YouTube to make sure that we are live. And now on YouTube, you can see that I'm also now live. Excellent connection. And now I can go ahead and engage with my chat and be able to go ahead and start building my community on YouTube. Then once you go ahead and you're done streaming, all you need to do is come back to your Xbox, hit manage your stream, and then you can go ahead and hit stop live streaming. And that's going to go ahead and stop the stream for you on both Twitch and YouTube. And just like that, you are now streaming to Twitch and YouTube at the same time utilizing just your Xbox. But if you want to learn how to stream to Kick from your Xbox, go ahead and watch this video right here where I walk you step by step on how to do just that. I'll see you guys in the next video.